Managing data distribution across expanding intercompany landscapes can be a complex and time-consuming task. Intercompany landscapes may not want to share all master data, which may not be relevant to specific branch companies and their local markets. With the new release of Intercompany Integration Solution 2.0 for SAP Business One 9.0, users are now enabled to create predefined data distribution templates, which makes sharing and replicating relevant data across different company branches simple. A data distribution template defines the custom recipient list for master data replication in SAP Business One companies within an intercompany landscape. A user can define a distribution template to replicate specific global business partners, global item master data, global bill of materials and master global price lists to specific branch companies. OEC Computer's Swiss head office based in Zurich are planning to launch a special sales campaign for IBM printers. The head office branch wants to launch this campaign from the Geneva office only. A number of new IBM printers have been received in stock, and OEC Computers plans to distribute the item master data for these printers to their Geneva branch in preparation for the sales campaign. A special campaign price list will also be used for these items for the period of the campaign. I am now logged in as the OEC Company Manager for Head Office based in Zurich, and I'd like to assign my colleague Alex Bergen the appropriate authorizations to manage all data distribution across OEC's intercompany landscape. To do this, I need to navigate to Administration, Setup, Intercompany, and select Global Data Authorizations. I'm going to assign Alex full authorization for managing data distribution. You have the option to assign full or selective authorization for global data distribution depending on the user's role in the organization. So now Alex has full authorization to add, update or remove business partner, bill of material, price list or global item master data. So now I'm going to log in as Alex Bergen to perform the data distribution for the sales campaign. So now I'm logged in as Alex Bergen, I want to perform the data distribution for our sales campaign. So firstly, we need to navigate to Administration, Setup, Intercompany, and then we need to open the Global Data Distribution Template window. We would now like to replicate IBM item master data and a special campaign price list between Branch 1 based in Geneva and the head office company based in Zurich. To do this, we're going to create a new template. Firstly, we need to define a new template code, and we're going to call it IBM Campaign. Then we need to select the object that we want to replicate, and in this case, the object is an item. Now we have a list of branches within our intercompany landscape that we can select for replication within this global data distribution template. We're going to select Branch 1 and Head Office. We're now going to create a data distribution template for our new campaign price list. Again, we can select a template code as being IBM Campaign price list. The object for replication is a price list, and again we need to select the branches that we want to replicate the data between, which will be Branch 1 and our head office branch. These data distribution templates will now be replicated across all branch companies. Let's now log into our Geneva branch to check the results of the replication. We're now logged into branch 1 of our Geneva branch, and in the alerts inbox, we can see two intercompany notifications, which has notified us that two templates have been replicated successfully. Our first global template was successfully created for our item distribution, and the second template was created for our price list replication. When creating new master data, users can also attach these distribution templates to groups, such as item groups, customer groups, or vendor groups, where the definitions will then flow automatically to the item and business partner master data within the groups. So we're going to log back into our head office company system, and we're going to create a new item group and assign the distribution template to it. Back in the head office company system, we're now going to create a new item group and assign the distribution template to it. And to do this, we need to navigate to Administration, Setup, Inventory, and Inventory Item Group. We're going to create a new item group name called IBM Campaign 2013. And then we've got the ability to assign our distribution template that we created to this item group. By clicking on the tab button, we're presented with a list of all the distribution templates that have been created, and we're going to add our IBM campaign template that we created to this particular item group. Now, the items assigned to this item group will only be replicated in the head office company database and the branch 1 Geneva company database. So now the item group is created with this template. And now we're going to create a new price list for our IBM campaign. To do this, we need to navigate to price lists. We navigate to inventory, price lists, and we open up the price list window. So let's define a new price list for our IBM campaign and then assign the global data distribution template that we created to this campaign price list. So firstly, we're going to rename our price list as IBM campaign. We're going to indicate and enable this price list to be a global price list. And now we can assign a distribution template against this price list, which will be the IBM campaign price list distribution template. And now we're going to assign some special prices to the items that are relevant for this same campaign, to this campaign price list. So we're going to assign the required pricing for this particular campaign for the items involved in this campaign. So now we have created and defined a new price list for our sales campaign. We have enabled this price list to be a global price list, and we have assigned our appropriate distribution template that we created for this particular sales campaign. We're now going to create a new item under Item Master Data. In Add mode, we can now include an item number and an item description. We also want to assign this item to the item group that is part of our global data distribution template, which is under IBM Campaign 2013. We also want to associate this item as a global item. And by doing so, the default distribution template code that we created for this particular sales campaign has been added automatically. So upon checking this item as a global item, the distribution template is automatically assigned to this item due to the item group definitions. And if required, a user can change this template code before adding the item to the system. We'll also assign a unit price. And now we can add the item to the system. There are three more IBM printer items that we want to add to this campaign and replicate to our Geneva branch that are already in the head office system. So we're going to navigate to these items, and we're also going to enable them as a global item. And by changing the item group to our item campaign, our distribution template code has automatically been added. So we're going to update this item. Now we're going to do that for the remaining two items. And for our final IBM printer, we'll ensure that this item is also added to our sales campaign. So now we've created two specific data distribution templates for our IBM sales campaign and included four items and a sales campaign price list for replication. So let's now check the replication of these items and the price list in the Geneva Branch 1 company. We're now logged into our Geneva Branch company database. And as you can see, there's a number of intercompany notifications in our alerts inbox. We first received two alerts for creating the data distribution templates, which have been replicated, and they're actually replicated into all branches within the intercompany landscape. We've also received an intercompany notification for the new item group that we created, and that item group was the IBM campaign 2013 item group. We've also received a notification for the price list that we've created for our sales campaign as well. So as you can see, there's a replication that has occurred for the IBM campaign price list that we've created specifically for this sales campaign. In addition to that, we've got the replication of the item master data. If we click on the items, we can see that the item master data, by drilling down into the item, has also been replicated within the Geneva Branch company database. And that's the same for the other items that we replicated as well. Let's now log into the Burn Branch, Branch 2, to see what the effects were of the replication process as well. We're now logged into the Burn Branch, Branch 2, and in our Alerts Overview inbox, we can see three intercompany notifications. The first two intercompany notifications are the data distribution templates that we created, and again, these templates are replicated across all branches within the intercompany landscape. And then the third intercompany notification was the item group that we created. But as you can see here, the items that were associated with the item group have not been replicated, and also the price list specific to this particular sales campaign has also not been added to this particular branch company. Please note that once data distribution templates have been attached to an item and added to the system, they can't be removed. So now we can run our IBM sales campaign for our Geneva branch, having replicated the required master data and pricing updates for this specific campaign. As we have demonstrated, with the new release of the Intercompany Integration Solution 2.0 for SAP Business One 9.0, users can easily create predefined data distribution templates for sharing and distributing data across the intercompany landscape to support specific local business process requirements.